Hi, everybody. Happy Martin Luther King Jr. Day. This is Nancy Weinbeck, CEO at Bayview, here for another weekly video update. We received confirmation today that another staff person did test positive for COVID. We're putting a memo out and just wanted to reassure everybody, this is somebody that is part of the administrative staff of our health center. And as such, they have no contact with residents and very minimal contact actually with other staff. They are asymptomatic and they are quarantining at home until they are meeting the time that they're allowed to come back to Bayview. So for 2020 and 2021, we have a total of 6 cases, right? 4 staff total and 2 residents total. But of that, we only have 2 active cases at this point. One is the resident who is recovering and actually may not even be considered an active case at this point. I have to check the dates on that. And the other is the staff person who is active but asymptomatic. So that's where we're at with COVID. From where I sit here, Jill and I filming on the 10th floor, I see a large, beautiful house a couple of blocks away from us. And I'm watching some kids on a trampoline with a basketball, trying to shoot a basketball through a hoop while they're jumping up and down on the trampoline. And so let's talk about vaccines, because it feels like we are on a trampoline jumping up and down trying to be steady to make a good shot with our basketball when the ground underneath us is not reliable. And that's where we're at. So we did get confirmation from CVS. They will be here on January 25th. They know very well we have an expectation that independent residents will be part of the vaccinations on that day. The governor has had an urgent phone call with both CVS and Walgreens saying this is his expectation as well. We, however, have not gotten confirmation from CVS on the number of vaccines they'll be bringing. We are acting as if there will be enough vaccine for our whole community. That has been the request. CVS knows that. We've been contacting them for many weeks, but unfortunately, they have not been the best at responding to our calls and emails with vaccine number. What we are doing is we are acting as if they received our number. We know they have, and they will be here with that number of vaccines. We are getting consent forms out this week so that we can be prepared and help CVS be prepared for the vaccine distribution on the 25th. And we have a plan in place for how that is going to roll, and we will get information out to all of you so you know where to go and what time to go to get your vaccine. Our belief is that they will be here on the 25th with enough vaccine for everyone. So get your consent forms filled out. Be prepared to be vaccinated on the 25th. If we receive any updated news from CVS, we will definitely let all of you know right away. Well, on a positive note, and speaking of communication, we received a communication from Comcast. They will be here with their X-ray equipment on the 21st. So that's later this week. Comcast will be here to X-ray. I believe they will be X-raying the east and west wings of the building where they will be doing the core drilling just to make sure they don't run into anything unexpected like live wires, which is what they found when they were here a few weeks back. So Again, Comcast will be here on the 21st for the x-ray. Once they do the x-rays, they will schedule the core drilling again. We'll hand out the earplugs again. And once that core drilling happens, then they can drop the cabling down and start their apartment to apartment conversion. Making progress. Today, as a day to honor Dr. King, I was looking at all of his many inspirational quotes, not all of them, but some of them. There were so many wonderful, inspiring words that he communicated to so many Americans and people all over the world. But one of those quotes in particular grabbed me today, I think just because of how frustrating our situation is with COVID and with the vaccine, especially when it's so close to, you know, everybody being protected and being able to go back to or move forward with life not restricted by COVID. His quote that I shared was, I have decided to choose love because hate is too big a burden to bear. And I may have paraphrased that a bit, but I choose love, and that's why I'm here at Bayview. And I am grateful each and every day for having the opportunity to serve. So thank you, and have a wonderful Dr. Martin Luther King Day, and have a wonderful week.